Hello everybody, welcome to LivesBerg Enterprise. Today we have got a special guest with us. She is a magnificent and gorgeous lady. She is the managing director of Petal groups of schools which are established almost everywhere in India. She is also a parent coach and has been taking multiple parenting sessions. When we talk about kids development, kids are involved. It's about the environment, it's about the teachers and also about the parents. She is ensuring that she is giving a healthy environment at the school and at the same time ensuring that kids are getting healthy environment at home. These schools are following the best practices from all over the globe to ensure that there are age-appropriate activities for the kids. And they ensure that they start their schools with the kids with the happy songs. Please help me in welcoming Preeti Kwatra.
Thank you so much.
Hello. So Preeti ma'am, please share with us your life journey. You have attained success in a very short span of time and you initiated your entrepreneurship in a very early age. Please share with us.
This journey is very enriching. I have learned a lot from my own journey, right? And as you know, I have started my journey at the age of 23, yes. Right? That is the first time when I said, yes, I have to do it. Right, and then I started and now it's been almost 16 years. We started with 5 students and now we have more than 5,000 students with us.
That's wonderful. So what is that inspiration or what was that zeal which gave the signal to this drive to initiate and to have this entrepreneurship and to success at this high rate?
See, most important thing is I don't look at anyone, but I'm doing it for myself. This is my driving force. Every day, whenever day ends, I just revive the whole day, what I have done for me and what I have, I'm able to contribute some in somebody's life or in society.
Wonderful.
This is how I end my day. And next day, what new I'm going to do, because I get bored very easily.
Okay, everybody does.
So if boring things hote rahe aur wo sab normal chalta raha to maza nahi aata, you know, aur agar sab kehte hain sab theek chal raha hai to mujhe lagta hai kuch gadbad hai.
Yeah, bilkul, absolutely,
you know. To jab hum log heartbeat check karte hain, agar flat line aa jaye, something is missing.
That's dead person.
So jisko kehte hain na, I want more every day. That's a spirit I have. Right. What else we can do? How can we contribute more?
Right.
You know, all these things help me, you know, to stay focused on my goal.
Wonderful, wonderful. So you advocate the fact that the more we give is more we get.
Yes, yes.
And you believe in serving other people.
I do.
Wonderful.
I do. Because of that, see, not only in our schools only, but we serve and I have taken the initiative. We have adopted 5 prisons also.
Wonderful.
And there we help teachers and inmates, those who are in inside the prison, to inculcate the right values and right education to the children, those who are there in the crutch.
Right. What do you think that, what kind of education or what kind of mindset is required in our early youth? So we say that schooling is the formative years, but do you see that the schools are actually providing the right kind of mindset which is required for whole life?
See, schools, I hope nobody should object, but schools are providing curriculum, right? Schools are providing what is given in the books. But it is now available on Google. That is why my children sometimes used to ask, "Mama, why do we go to school? We can study this thing at home."
Right.
I think school need to more focus on life skills, which is going to be responsible for the success
of kids.
Success for the human mankind.
True.
Right. There are so many people, those who don't know why I have studied Second World War. There are so many people who don't know why we have tortured to study trigonometry.
Right. True.
Right.
True.
But skills which are required to be successful in life, it's not like 9 to 6 ka job karo and earn your living.
Right.
Life is far more bigger than that.
Right.
Right. We need to teach our children that these are the basic concept which is need to be learned at this age, which you should know. Right, only thing is you should know. That is why so many things are coming up, like assessment remove kar do, only observation karo. We have to understand what is the core of that. The core is we have to focus more on values, less on rectification.
True, absolutely. So we have just talked about creating the citizens of the future. That's just wonderful.
Preeti, and future, I would like to add in this, future belongs to leaders.
Right.
Those who, you know, follow their, what they believe in. Future doesn't belong to, sab theek hai, acha hai, what's wrong with it, you know. If everybody would think like this, then whose dream will come true?
Right.
Nobody's.
Right. So how do you think that kids can learn leadership, or do you advocate the fact that leaders only mean that I join an organization and I become some manager or leader?
No.
Or kids can also learn leadership at school despite whatever class they are in. So does it mean that we can learn leadership right when I'm in first class, or maybe when I'm in preschool?
See, leader word itself has first four letter, lead. Lead, but who will lead? The people has to understand, those who believe in right or wrong is secondary, right? You have to lead in the sense, if you are saying this is right, then you should have a specific reason, right? And you will become leader once you follow your passion without second thought.
Right.
It is not necessary if somebody is successful as a chef, or somebody is successful as an entrepreneur. So you will also do you will also get success while following that thing. No, leaders are those who follow their vision, their passion. Because whenever you will work for your passion, you know, your brains automatically start thinking what else you can do, and what add on you can do to make it more creative. We take your example only, because I have met you not many times, right? But still, if you are doing what is your passion, then nobody is there to give you the idea. You will automatically get the idea. You will start thinking because your whole focus is on that. Right? Your whole brain 360 degree will think about it.
Right.
Or in case due to some unavoidable circumstances, some panic will come, then also you are able to handle it, because you have chosen this thing. This is your choice. Right, and you will learn out of each mistake.
Right. So when primarily our audiences are the school kids and job seekers or the college kids, how can you mentor them on, you know, maybe top three application points which they can follow and they can become leader in whatever age they are, whatever domain they are?
Okay. If you follow, want to have a 3 points, the first is find out which you enjoyed the most. That is your passion.
So kids can identify the activities
which they enjoy the most.
Wonderful.
Right? You can say, aapne suna hoga na ki, what do you call that? Kis tarah ke pair hote hai, palne mein hi pata lag jate hai, you know?
Poot ke pair palne
mein hi pata lag jate hai. Aisa kuch hai na? Hai na? So there are people, jab hum jab chote hote hai, to hum log wo housey jab play karte hai, nahi main hi manunga papa. Because I will decide what will happen.
Oh, right? That's the decision making thing.
Right, decision making thing, right? And main banungi mamma, main sabka dhyan rakhungi, you know? As a caretaker, I will take care of everyone. So when children observe their parents and their environment, they decide their role which they like the most. You have seen many girls, those who start following their dad, papa ki tarah briefcase leke office se aana, leg pe leg rakke baithna, mere liye ye lekar aao, you know. So those skills are automatically, you know, knowingly or unknowingly is going inside her. And one day subconsciously she dreams of ki maybe ek din aise office jaungi, main bhi aise karungi. So first and foremost is the activity which you enjoyed the most, and that is passion. Identify that and follow it.
All right. So what you are trying to say, that once kids are following the activities which they like, they are doing it more, some way or the other, they are actually following their passion.
Yes, but sometime it happens different for everyone, right? Mm-hmm. Sometime it is a big, due to the activities, and sometime they identified it later while looking at other people. Mm-hmm. And sometime, you know, they get inspired by some movie. Mm-hmm. You know, media mm-hmm. has a lot of effect on our children.
Absolutely.
Sometime they inspired by somebody's lifestyle, mm-hmm. that we want to have that lifestyle. Like, mm-hmm. you know, so many people, those who want to go in fashion industry, mm-hmm. they get inspired by models, mm-hmm. actresses, mm-hmm. and no profession is less than the other.
True, absolutely.
If you are enjoying it, mm-hmm. but if in the morning you don't want to go to the office, mm-hmm. right, that means that is not your
you
passion.
Are not loving that
you're not loving that job.
Right. So the one way we can identify our passion, even when I'm a school kid, is yeah. that I follow and I keep doing the activities which I like,
yeah.
and I keep following my interest. And then, of course, do you also want to say that learning new things towards that passion
yes.
is also something which will gonna help me reach my dreams?
Yes, yes. Initially, parents used to put their children in a lot of activities, dance, guitar, mm-hmm. skating, you know, music, vocal, and but slowly and steadily, as the child grows, mama mujhe yahan nahi jana, is activity pe jana, acha isme main chala jaunga usme, that means somehow or the other the child is having an inclination towards that activity and the child is enjoying that activity. Mm-hmm. Right.
Right,
every parent wants their child to learn dance also, skating also, theater also, so many things are available mm-hmm. nowadays.
Mm-hmm.
But and some children love to enjoy cooking, mm-hmm. like their mama is cooking, right,
so
they can be a good chef and the great chef also.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Right. So first of all, as a parent, please don't pressurize your children to choose the profession.
Mm-hmm. Right. Right.
Let children to decide. Mm-hmm. It will bring, you know, it will bring responsibility. It will bring accountability.
Mm-hmm.
Right. You should not decide ki agar hum engineer hai to tujhe bhi engineer hi banna chahiye. Mm-hmm. You know, right. hum teaching profession mein hai to aapko teacher hi banna chahiye, because it's a half day job. Aap ghar aa jate ho, apni family ko bhi dekh paate ho. Why there are so many females in the education profession?
Mm-hmm.
Because unko lagta females ke liye theek hai. Har father or mother hi sochte jitna marzi padh le. But you know, end of the day, mein teaching is the best profession.
True, right.
It happens.
Right, right.
But I think agar aisa hota, to Kalpana Chawla, Indira Nooyi, ICICI Bank ke, your CEO, there are so many fields mm-hmm. which are deprived of good talent.
True, absolutely.
Right?
Absolutely.
If you are educated, it is your foremost responsibility to serve the society also, to the country also.
Right, absolutely.
And the second, you have asked three. And the second is never get afraid of failure.
Mm-hmm. Right, which is not taught in schools.
Yes.
In schools, failures is mistakes means punishment. Or you would not be allowed to attend this
school. तुमने कर कैसे दिया? मैंने तुम्हें पहले ही समझाया था, ऐसे करोगे तो ऐसे हो जाएगा. If every time you will ask the child, don't jump on sofa. If you ask the child, don't jump on sofa, then how will he come out with the, you know, one thing, fear of jumping.
Mm-hmm.
And the second thing is, the pleasure will the child will have while jumping.
Mm-hmm.
You are depriving your child out of that.
Right.
And he will come, he will not come out with a fear of height.
Mm-hmm.
Every time you're saying don't jump on sofa, you will get hurt.
Mm-hmm.
Arre, let him. But make sure the child should not get hurt. Sharp items should not be around. In the same way, to the youngsters and the adults, grown up, parents says, don't go there.
Mm-hmm.
Bad company is there. Mm-hmm. Don't go there. You know, people, mm-hmm. bad people are there. You will spoil your life. Aap bigad jaoge. Please nurture your children in such a way
mm-hmm.
that no external good or bad factor should affect the child.
Absolutely right. Absolutely.
Don't give him your fears.
True. True. That's
you want. Doing. You have a fear ki aapke bachche ko koi addiction na ho jaye.
To
aap ek 15 year, 19 year, 20 year bachche ko bhi ek, you know, four wall. I will call it a case or a jail, right? Mm-hmm. Rakhna chahte ho kyunki aapko lagta hai mera bachcha safe hai.
Mm-hmm.
But wo safe nahi hai. Wo life ki bahut sari skills nahi seekha.
Mm-hmm.
Let the child explore this world in his own way.
Right.
Maybe he may fail,
mm-hmm.
but you should have that kind of a bonding with a child or a youngster. If 30-year-old child also do some mistake, you should be the first person
mm-hmm.
to whom he will come. Dad or mom, aisa ho gaya.
Mm-hmm.
So you should be like, it's okay, ho gaya. Now, what lesson we have learned from it?
True, right.
And in future, let's not repeat the mistake.
Right. And if parents are watching this video, then I'm sure that we all parents want our kids to come to us and not to anyone else.
Yes.
to learn about new things, or even if they have made some mistake, that they are confident enough to come back to us seeking our guidance, or if not, that at least, you know, admitting that yes, this is what.
Or if your child is not coming to you, don't worry about that also. That means your child is doing introspection.
Mm-hmm.
Once the child is grown, say 15, 16 years, children definitely need someone, right? They will come. But after 15, 16, if they are not coming to you and you know the mistake has already happened, mm-hmm. right? Then I think they are introspecting and they will automatically, they have this power. I don't know from how, but they have this. So even I have failed a lot many times, right? Mm-hmm. And every human being or a child has a power to introspect and come out of that situation. And then when child himself will come out of the situation, then you can realize what will be the next day child,
mm-hmm.
you know, how confident the child will be.
Wonderful, wonderful. And I'm sure that our parents also want to know. I mean, of course, these are very valuable points she are discussing, because she is a parent coach and has given multiple sessions to parents, and we have also go through the feedback on Facebook of parents. They are so much in, they are so much fan of her that they want Petal schools to be there in their state also. So my question to you is that you just said that we can help, as a parent, we can help our kid to introspect. What could be those one or two points which we can ensure as a parent and to ensure that they introspect and they realize that what's wrong and what's right?
I think one thing, it comes itself, you know, in the children. And the second thing is that there is no second thought. Enriching environment nurtures the child.
Mm-hmm.
In that, parent plays a very important role, right? Let's take an example. If you are sharing one meal together at night, so
mm-hmm.
parents should have this habit to discuss one or two incident or a what do you call it, episode which has happened in a day,
mm-hmm.
so that parent can discuss with the children or in a family,
mm-hmm.
that this has happened in a day, but this was not correct, what I have realized is this,
mm-hmm.
right? And they can also discuss this was happened, but that was really good an idea, right?
Mm-hmm.
And it clicked, or this is all happened. If parents are doing this now, then it will come with the, in the children also.
Mm-hmm.
Like, we can discuss in a family, one thing. And the second most important thing is introspection.
Mm-hmm.
And the second point which I want to highlight is when the child is going to sleep,
mm-hmm.
right? You can sit with the child
mm-hmm.
and discuss.
Mm-hmm.
This is how your day was. Then child automatically come out. Ye mere saath bhi aise hua. Pata aaj meri friend ne aise kara. Ye aise hua. Today I have written, ma'am asked me to write a story and I have written this.
Wonderful.
You know, they were very enthusiastic towards telling you.
Mm-hmm.
But at that time, parents' role matters a lot. At that time, are you listening 100%?
Mm-hmm.
Or you are just listening for the sake of listening?
Mm-hmm. Right,
that matters.
Right. To have that powerful conversation with the kids, which
yes.
should empower
it should be
kids.
A two-way communication,
right? True.
One-way communication will not work.
Mm-hmm.
And the third most important point, first is passion,
mm-hmm.
second is learn from your failure,
mm-hmm.
and the third most important point is, if you find out your passion, then don't listen to anything
mm-hmm.
anyone is saying.
Mm-hmm.
When I started my journey this 16 years back at the age of 23, right, at that time my parents also were not ready to talk to me properly. They were saying, you are doing something, you know, which nobody has done in our family. We belong to service class. My mom was teacher, my dad was in Navy, and they all were saying ki koi nuksan ho gaya to, now you're married or you want to start a business. I have started from my own house, right? We started with 5 students and now this journey is going on.
Wonderful.
And now they are saying, we are proud of you. But if you have identified your passion, then don't give ears to anything. Then follow it. Once you have decided, all failure and successes belong to you. And success will come eventually if you believe in yourself.
Hmm.
So I believe passion, fear of failure should not be there. And the third thing is, just follow it blindly.
Mm-hmm.
Then nobody, and it is not written in any book, if you are at this age, then you are successful. You can be successful than your parents, which they have not done in their 20 or 50 years of life. You can do it in 5 years.
Right, right. There are so many entrepreneurs below 18 also.
Yes,
they are in school and they are entrepreneurs.
Yes, yes, yes.
So what, fear of failure definitely is, will be there, and we go through lots of failures when we wake up in the morning.
I think this is good.
Yeah.
That makes us more, you know, have more concentration towards
right.
our goal.
It is. But when we talk about school kids or college kids, they succumb, fear succumb them. It is to go through fears every day in the morning. So you, when you started off with your journey, or at any age when they are thinking to follow their dreams, to follow their goals, of course, parents would not support them, and I'm sure they want to know.
Sometimes, yes.
When parents are not supporting, which is majority of the cases, how as kids, we can handle our parents?
Okay, see, if you talk about younger kids, this problem does not come.
Mm-hmm.
Right. But if you talk about 18 plus children, right, there are some parents like if the child belongs to doctor family and child wants to be a musician, mm-hmm. then it's a challenge.
Absolutely.
It's a challenge. But at the same time, a child can sit with a parent that, mom, I really enjoy this.
Mm-hmm.
I think parents also understand what your child is enjoying is a little real instinct,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm.
What you enjoy the most, irrespective of you have spent 10 years, 12 years, 15 years in any profession, it is not a guarantee that you have enjoyed it.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Right? You can change any point of time in your life,
mm-hmm.
right? If you talk about one of the burger brand, if I can take the name of a brand, KFC,
mm-hmm.
he has started his KFC journey at the age of 70,
mm-hmm.
right?
Right, so, absolutely.
So parents and children need to sit together. They have to identify, and child has to convince the parent that really I enjoyed this thing.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to be a doctor. Yeah, I don't want to be an engineer, right? My mom was teacher and my mom really wants me to be a teacher,
mm-hmm.
right? I want to be in the education line, that is for sure, right? But I really want to start something of my own.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to go in a job,
mm-hmm.
right? Sometimes I feel, maine kabhi job nahi kiya, mujhe nahi pata ki, you know, job kaise hota hai. But I think everything has its pros and cons.
Mm-hmm. Right, right. So for the parents, those who are watching these videos,
yes.
the message is that they listen to their kids.
Yes.
And to the kids, if they have already identified what they want to do, maybe for a shorter span of time, they go and sit with their parents and make them understand and convince them this is what they want to do. And despite whatever comes, what your message is that they still keep following those dreams.
My daughter in class 7th only, she told me I want to be an Air Force officer.
Wonderful.
You know, or ISI officer, second choices. So in my family, people have started saying, why to become Air Force officer?
Mm-hmm.
You know, life risk is there and she will go out of the house most of the time, and fighter plane, why to fly the fighter plane, you can become a pilot, because they are asking her to compromise,
mm-hmm.
you know, although their pilot has the same responsibility which fighter pilot has,
right,
right? He is supposed to take the passengers to the next destination,
mm-hmm.
but fighter pilot need to move here and there, then they are asking her to compromise. If she is not compromising, ki I have decided, I am not ready to listen, so I am happy,
mm-hmm.
I am with her,
mm-hmm.
I am not asking her to compromise on her dreams,
right.
Right?
Right.
So at least she have a subconsciously trust that my mom is there with me.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if this trust is there in children,
mm-hmm.
from a parent's side, then children will do wonders.
They become their friends with the parents.
I hope so. But it's a challenge.
Yeah, of course it's a challenge. It's a challenge. Why? Because when parents or relatives are saying don't go for fighting plane or something which involves risk, they are more concerned about the survival or the safety of the life. However, these things creep fear in kids, or this frustration of not fulfilling their dreams,
yes.
which I believe that parents are not able to understand. But then once they start understanding that their kids' dreams are our dreams, and at least let them blossom and believe in their own potential and be with them, I believe that parent and kids can be friends, can be more than friends.
In this responsibility on the child's shoulder comes a lot,
mm-hmm.
right? And even child should also remember this, not only parents, but child should also remember ki whatever you are saying and to the parents and whatever you are deciding, then you need to perform for that,
mm-hmm.
right? Nothing comes easy.
Then my dreams are my responsibility,
yes.
no one else's.
Uh-huh.
Right.
Right. Then you have to. You are responsible that each stone should be unturned,
mm-hmm.
to achieve your dreams.
Right.
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 Then you cannot say today it's very cold, or I don't want to go to the office,
mm-hmm.
or I will. Nahi hua exam clear, so next time they don't go. No, there mm-hmm. is no next time. Then you are responsible.
Right.
Then performance has to be there. The responsibility on the children will come once the parent trusts them,
mm-hmm.
and children also need to understand that, yes, now I have to prove.
Right, right. So you were sharing your story. There have been distant from the parents. They were not able to understand. What were three things which helped you still keep driving your dreams? Because yes, we maybe somewhere we as kids are convinced that yes, we need to keep our dreams, keep thinking, keep moving, but it's not easy. We are with our parents and they are not believing in our dreams. What were those three mindsets or three practices which you were following to ensure that you were right there on the dreams, kind of everyday practice?
First thing, mujhe pata hai main kar lungi.
That belief in myself.
Belief.
Wonderful.
I have to do it. Right? And the second thing is, when I have first have I decided, then does not matter who is speaking what. I can try to pacify them. Yes, please understand. I will do. Yes. And the third most important thing is, I have not compromised on my dreams on the stake of many other things. Like, you have to compromise your health up to certain extent. You have to compromise on your daily routine up to certain extents. Yes, you have to, but don't compromise on your dream. Don't compromise.
Wonderful.
Then you have to believe, don't listen to anyone, and follow it. Then you have to prove, yes, I have done it.
Then you have a goal set for yourself.
Till today I cannot say I have done it.
Wonderful, because it's a lifelong journey.
Might be, I'm looking for more.
Yes. So, belief in myself, determination, and the passion that nothing can stop me, and yes, I am ready to get that at any cost.
Yes. There's a story of a frog. I was discussing the story with one of my colleague on that day, that she was upset with something and people were saying to her something. Then I discussed with her, there was one pole. One frog tried to climb it up. I think it's a very well-known story, right? One frog tried to climb that but slipped down. Another two, three frog tried. Then it become a community. Like, nobody can climb this pillar, right? So everybody was saying, ye bekar hai, you know, you cannot climb it up. All of a sudden, one frog came and the frog was trying to climb. And everybody was saying, come down, it's a waste of time, don't try this, we have already tried this, it is not going to be happen, you cannot climb this. And but that frog tried and reached the point of the main top of the pole. Could you tell me how come this frog has make it possible?
Determination, self-belief.
Okay, the reason why I tell you the reason, this is not the reason. The reason why that frog get success is because he was deaf and dumb.
Okay, alright.
So every frog was saying him, come down. So he was thinking, everybody is saying, you can do it, you can do it. Go ahead, I am with you, go ahead. So he took his journey and he did it.
So what we have learned from this story, this is such an amazing story, thank you for sharing. So what we can learn from the story is that despite people are saying no, we can become deaf and dumb like that frog and
yes,
consider that no as yes, you can do it, yes, you can do it. And yes, we can do it. That's what we can do.
And the small incidents, you can use it. So one, it's a very funny story, but I have used it as an example. My son was young and we were traveling somewhere for vacations and he was saying, I want to go in a business class, right? So we said, no, we have bought the tickets of economy class, premium economy class, and he used to wear shorts, you know, shorts at home and loose t-shirts, which usually kids love to have. But on that day, early in the morning, we have a flight early morning, so he wore coat, pants and shirts and proper. And then we were surprised, what are you doing? He said, I want to travel in business class, and in business class formals are allowed. So we were all laughing among ourselves, okay, that what is happening. We went to the airport and over there, I don't know what happened, and he requested the crew person,
okay,
that I want to travel by business class, if you have any seat something, so we need four seats. Papa, mama, my sister and me. I don't know how he requested the lady and what happened, and she has given him a two business class tickets.
Wonderful,
right? So I was surprised and I was quiet. The both were sitting, you know, ahead of us in business class, we were there and all these things were happening. He was young at that time. I was shocked also and I was very happy also. So that incident, I have used it as a, you know, practice for my child and a motivational quote, ki son, whatever you decide first, then go ahead for that.
Right.
Irrespective of what the others are saying. We were all laughing earlier, right? Mm-hmm. We were all laughing. Mm-hmm. But he did it. He was, you know, he was imagining that I am traveling in a business class.
Right.
And when he reached Hong Kong, he was so happy that, Mama, see, that I am so proud of you.
Yeah,
that's what I want to teach you. Mm-hmm. See, whenever you decide something, then don't listen and follow.
Absolutely, absolutely. So he set a goal for himself. He envisioned himself sitting and traveling in the business class, and he could do it. The foremost thing is ask. Unless and until we ask, we don't get it.
Yes.
And in that plane, I'm sure there were multiple other people, but they did not attempt to ask.
Yes.
This is very important that we ask. And that's when we ask our kids to go back, sit with their parents and at least talk and ask them, see, this is what I want to do. That is okay. So Preeti ma'am, what do you have to say about increasing suicide rates among school students? And this is primarily the public school students. Mm. And also about the increasing crime rate when kids are bullying other kids and then ending up murdering other kids. I don't want to use this word, but then this is the word. And then increasing pornography. And there are kids, those are assaulting other kids. So the worst of all the cases I heard was then when 4-year young boy assaulted another 4-year young girl. They don't know what they are doing. But then what do you have to say on all these increasing crimes?
This is a very, very sad situation. What is happening? It is one of the reason why it is happening is overexposure of media, right? Overflow of communication, of knowledge, first of all, and lack of connect with the parents. If parents, they will learn from the parents, then this will not happen, right? And the third most important thing is lack of values. We all are going in a wrong direction. We all want our children should score good. But what will happen if they will not have the character? What will happen if you score 100% and you don't know how to handle the failure?
Right.
What will happen if your child is scoring 97% and somehow at some stage he will score 92% and he is going for suicide? This is really saddening and alarming situation. We all have to work together. Everyone, like as a society, as a strong pillar of the society, parents and school heads and counselors, psychologists, all need to come together. Who is see, who is our future? Our children is our future.
Absolutely.
And we all have to work. Our children don't need report cards. Our children don't need 5-star schools. But what our children need is a person who can inculcate values.
Right.
A person who can teach or make them emotionally strong. A you are discussing with me, lot many IITians are leaving IIT just because of fear of a suicide.
Right.
See, they are finding to do a suicide is very easy rather than studying in IIT. That means first thing, again, which we have discussed, they're not following their passion. They have clear IIT entrance just because somebody else is saying, if you clear the IIT, then you will be successful.
Right.
If you are married and if you are having 1 or 2 children, you are successful.
Right.
No, these are not the status symbol or these are not the checklist of a success. Checklist of a success is whenever any challenges come in life, real life, I'm talking about real life, you know, and life has very less instances of success and many more of failure.
Right.
Every day we have discussed a lot many things. Right.
Right.
And we face a lot of failure. But if our children are not ready to accept it, if our teachers are not teaching them, it is okay if you're not scoring full, but at least concept it clear to them. I don't think so. We are going to win the battle. Our children are facing, a lot of children are facing depression. A lot of children are going in loneliness. A lot of children are not understanding why we are here. Why we are teaching, why we are studying, you know, and why we should have a Facebook. And they are still on Facebook, right? Because of social stigma. तुम्हारे कितने फ्रेंड्स हैं, मेरे कितने फ्रेंड्स हैं, तुम्हारे को कितने लाइक्स आए, हमारे को कितने. आई नो पीपल और चिल्ड्रन. आई वाज काउंसलिंग वन चाइल्ड एंड अ मदर लास्ट मंथ दैट girls went into the depression when she has posted her photographs and she got only 32 likes.
Yeah, absolutely right.
You know?
Yeah, right.
Right. And this is so sad.
Right.
Right. You need somebody's approval for yourself.
Right. Because of lack of love.
Right. And it is not only among children. Even I have seen young couples also. Right. And they are posting their real life pictures and which is very unsafe.
True. True.
Right. And in school and in on the parent.
The great responsibility is on the parent and the teachers to accept the child as it is.
Right.
Please accept the child with his weaknesses and stress.
Mm-hmm.
If you pressurize the child will bring his anxiety or his aggression in some way or the other.
Mm.
Either the child will harm himself mm-hmm. or either the child will harm somebody else.
Right.
The children, those who bully other children, they themselves are going through some inferiority complex.
Absolutely.
You know, and they are, you know, coming out of that inferiority complex by bullying someone else.
Right. Right.
But if they are bullying someone, the child who is getting bullied, right, the child is feeling, I am lacking something, that is why they are bullying me.
Mm-hmm.
And then it's a child, parent and a teacher responsibility to tell the child, you are absolutely okay as you are.
Mm-hmm. Right.
You are okay if you are dark. You are okay if you are scoring less. You are okay because you are okay.
Right.
We still love you.
Mm.
Our love should not be conditional.
Right.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Then all these problems, we have seen one great movie, Three Idiots.
Mm-hmm.
Right. The child was finding that suicide is easier than doing engineering.
Right.
Hmm. Right. So it is our responsibility. The responsibility is on the stakeholders, hmm. parents and the teacher to tell the child.
Hmm.
Then parents should not ask this interview or argue on this, that one side ma'am is saying follow your passion, help your child to dream big, and the secondly ma'am is saying you are okay to be okay. What I want to say is, please accept your child as it is. If you really want your child to be a leader, then inculcate leadership values.
Hmm.
And most important leadership value is to how to balance a life. I am as a leader every day. It's not like if I'm sitting on this seat or the person who is a CEO of some company or some other MD is not facing challenges.
Mm-hmm. Right.
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 We all have to face some challenges and we have to balance our life.
Right.
And we have to be emotionally very, very strong.
Right.
And this is what we need to teach our children.
Right. So you have been a parent coach and you're also running your schools. What if parents have been tuned or raised up in a manner and primarily they are raising their kids in the same manner,
right,
because they believe that's the right thing. However, when it comes to accepting our kids as they are, how can they do that when they have not accepted themselves? How can they teach love myself to kids when they don't know and they don't love themselves? Same goes for teachers, same goes for parents. When these two category of humans, they don't know what love myself is and they don't love themselves, they don't believe in their dreams or dreaming big, how can they inculcate those values in the kids? What kids can do at that point in time?
Oh my,
when
gosh,
parents and teachers both.
She has touched a very hot topic. This is all about consciousness, Pooja.
Mm-hmm.
This is all about consciousness. See, first of all, this is what I say. The parents are carrying their old baggages of old parenting,
mm-hmm.
right? And they are throwing those baggages and forwarding those baggages to their children.
Right.
You have to understand, you have to love yourself. The four most important point which she has highlighted, start loving yourself, right?
It's very important.
It's very, very important. I am my favorite,
mm-hmm.
right?
Me too.
Yeah, see, and I think every leader
mm-hmm.
is their own favorite, because once you start believing what you are doing and you start following it,
mm.
you don't need anybody's approval.
Absolutely.
Right.
We always seek approval of our parents, of our peers, of our teachers, especially for kids.
Sometimes you have seen teenagers say, "Meri friend hai Sia, uski mama bahut achhi hai." वो इसीलिए बोल रही है क्योंकि उसकी मम्मा ने कभी अपने आप को अप्रूव नहीं किया, तो वो सिया को कैसे अप्रूव करेगी? बट उसकी फ्रेंड की मम्मा सिया को दूर से जानती है कि सिया आप तो बहुत अच्छे हो, यू नो. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, पेरेंट्स नीड टू स्टार्ट लविंग देमसेल्फ, देन दे स्टार्ट लविंग व्हाट दे डू इरिस्पेक्टिव ऑफ व्हाट दे डू, राइट? एंड देन दे स्टार्ट लविंग द चाइल्ड. यू एंड मी are not just bodies, right?
Mm-hmm.
We are breathing the same air.
Right.
You and me are same,
mm-hmm.
just with the different features,
mm-hmm.
right?
Right.
Come out of that, right? You are okay what you are doing. I am okay what I am doing,
mm-hmm.
it, right? When parents don't love themselves, they also put conditions on a child up. अगर तुम्हारे मार्क्स अच्छा है तो वी विल डू दिस,
राइट?
इफ यू विल बिकम दिस, यू विल डू दिस. और अदरवाइज व्हाट सबकॉन्शियसली दे नो इज, इफ यू हैव बिकम इंजीनियर देन यू विल बी सक्सेसफुल,
राइट?
इफ यू हैव अ सन, लाइक लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स दिस टाइम आल्सो आई एम लिसनिंग, इफ यू हैव अ सन देन यू हैव अ सक्सेसफुल, यू नो, फैमिली. This happens.
We still
Yes, we do still have this. You know, now you have become daughter-in-law, your foremost responsibility is to take care of the house. Mm-hmm. You know, the girls start feeling inferior.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Right. For gender bias, nahi hona chahiye parents ko, or uske baad, what do you call that? Koi parameters nahi set kari. Marks are not the parameters of life, mm-hmm. you know. Mm-hmm. Good looking is not the parameter of a life.
Right.
Good driving is not the parameter of life. Namaste or paath karna is not the parameter of life.
Right.
Make the, if you want your child to be spiritual, many parents ask from me, when spirituality kaise inculcate kare? Spirituality, once you will become spirituality.
Right.
Spirituality means give respect.
Mm-hmm. True, absolutely.
Understand the other person.
Mm.
And look at the other person as you are.
Right. Wonderful. Right. Wonderful thought. Right. Wonderful. Wonderful. So what you have just advocated, that despite I am a 5-year young kid or 15-year young kid or 50-year young adult, I must love myself without thinking if my parents know it, they do it or not, if my teachers know it, do it or not. But I need to be confident and I must love myself despite what others think about me.
See, you cannot preach that thing which you are not doing it.
Right. Absolutely. Absolutely. So it's not just parents' responsibilities or teachers' responsibilities. Even kids can be aware of the fact that the foremost thing is to love myself, as you just mentioned, and do the activities, daily activities. And do you also agree on the fact that these things, these must be the rituals, daily rituals of loving myself? Only then we are able to inculcate it so much that it becomes the DNA of our body.
And young age, like, you know, childhood, 2 to 8 years or 2 to 15 years, lot of time at the time of puberty or adolescence, children start having complex, you know, and they look at the other children.
Right.
She is fair, you know, India may have fair, you are beautiful.
Ah, yeah.
She has a, you know, she has a boyfriends and she has a long hair and she is thin, she is fat. The boy is kind of, he is looking smart, he is brand consciousness and all these stuff come in teenage. At that time, the parents has to tell your child, has to, that I am okay with as you are. Mm. I still love you, irrespective of your strengths and weaknesses. And it's a parent's responsibility, because parents are the first person with whom the child interacts.
Absolutely.
Parents are the first influencer on the child.
Absolutely.
Right?
Absolutely. And after that, of course, the teachers. Kids are fond of their teachers after mothers.
They do.
Yeah, of course, absolutely right. So it's important that despite what age we are in, we must love ourselves, accept ourselves as we are, so that others accept us the way we are.
Yeah.
Wonderful. What are the 3 success mantras which kids of schools can implement in their life, maybe on daily basis, as we just talked about, it's a daily ritual.
Mm.
What 3 things they can do every day, which would make them get closer to their dreams? So one, if they have already identified their dreams, or if they have not identified their dreams, but what would motivate them every day for 3 success mantras you want?
So first and foremost important thing is happiness is very important for a child. A child should feel happy at any cost, right? Feel happy irrespective of the circumstances, right? And because happiness cannot be decided by anything. If I'm saying anything, that means anything, right?
Mm-hmm.
And the second foremost important thing is start studying for yourself. Don't study for your parents, for your friend, for your tuition teacher. You know, don't study study should not come out of fear, right? Mere marks nahi aaye to mama naraaz ho jayegi, you know, tuition teacher gussa karegi, ya mere friends ke piche mera naam niche aayega. No, start studying for yourself. Marks are secondary. So if you start studying for yourself, then you don't need anybody's. But yes, I understand sometimes parents do nagging, teachers do nagging. Ye kar lo, ye board mein aa sakta hai, isko aise kar lo, tabhi to marks achche score karoge, aise karoge. 8 ghante padhoge, tabhi ho sakta hai, breaks mat lo, tab ho sakta hai. Continuously padho, concentration banao. Are concentration karna to sikha do. Concentration se padho, kya matlab hai concentration se padhne ka, right? Once you are not enjoying, you cannot concentrate. Right.
Right,
everybody says, किसी स्कूल में कोई पेरेंट अपने बच्चे को कंसंट्रेशन करना सिखाता है कभी?
Right.
हर पेरेंट और हर बच्चा और हर टीचर ये वर्ड सुनता है, आजकल के बच्चों की कंसंट्रेशन नहीं है, ये हर सेकंड पेरेंट मुझे कहता है. और टीचर्स कहते हैं कंसंट्रेशन से पढ़ो, पेरेंट कहते हैं कंसंट्रेशन से अपनी टेबल पे बैठ, what do you mean by concentration? Yeah. Right? You are not telling study for yourself. You are not staying asking child to be happy. जो काम करने में वो हैप्पी नहीं है वो कैसे कंसंट्रेशन करेगा उसके अंदर और कैसे उसको अचीव करेगा. आपको उसको फ़ोन पे गेम खेलना तो नहीं सिखाना पड़ता. और मेरे पास पेरेंट्स आते हैं कि मैम जब ये गेम खेल रहा होता है उसकी कंसंट्रेशन बहुत अच्छी होती है और पढ़ रहा होता है तो नहीं होती क्योंकि वो गेम को एंजॉय कर रहा है. उससे माँ आप उसको नेगिंग नहीं कर रहे कि 10 मिनट में खत्म कर 15 मिनट कर ये लेवल तूने जीतना ही जीतना है इस लेवल के अगले लेवल में तूने जाना ही जाना है यू नो ऑल दोज थिंग्स. तो स्टॉप नेगिंग योर चिल्ड्रन. और अगर बच्चे उनको पेरेंट्स कर भी रहे हैं तो टेक अ चिल पिल रिलैक्स इट्स अ कूल जर्नेशन यू नो यू शुड नो हाउ टू एंजॉय दिस फेज. सो पेरेंट्स को कहने दो गिव देम अ वेरी बिग स्माइल एंड एंजॉय राइट. एंड द थर्ड मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग इज चूज योर फ्रेंड्स वाइजली. दे प्ले एक्चुअली अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल इन योर लाइफ बट येस दे आर द फर्स्ट वन विद हुम यू स्माइल यू लाफ. इफ यू हैव एनी प्रॉब्लम तो आई सजेस्ट यू शुड गो फर्स्ट टू योर पेरेंट्स नॉट टू योर फ्रेंड्स. Friends are of your age, right? It is not wise to take advice from them. It is okay, you are opening your heart with them and they are listening to you. They are the best listener, right? But I think for the solution, you should go to your parents. Yeah. And if you are not able to go there, then introspect and relax. Right. And every situation will become okay in 3 to 4 days.
Wonderful, wonderful. So situations are not that bad, but we make our life complicated.
We do.
This goes for everyone.
All right. We take life very seriously.
Right, true. It's not that serious.
It's not that serious.
Yeah. All right. So the last question is that I'm sure despite you look so energetic, so vibrant and of course gorgeous, but still there are times when you are feeling low, when you are feeling that things are not going the way you want them to go. How do you switch yourself from that low mindset to happy and vibrant mindset?
See, yes, there are times when I feel very low, when I faced failure or when I want the situation or a process should happen like this, but it turned out to be something different, which is very shameful sometime, which is very demotivating sometime. Even I have faced all these things. But the way to introspect is, the way I introspect is, I become quiet, to be very frank. And I do a lot of question and answer with myself, why it happens and now what would be the circumstances. And if actually it happens, then now what should I do? Because the things which has already happened, you cannot control that. Now what is the best thing or what is the best version of myself in this situation? I always work on that, right? What is the best version I can do now? Chicken, suppose it is for the parents and it is for the students and it is for everyone. Failure comes in our life. But now what next? You need to face that boldly. Don't become you are, don't tag yourself that you are a failure.
Look for solutions.
Failure has already happened. Now what next? What next is, what is the best version of you at that time? Are you ready to face it? Face it boldly. Next time I will take care. Tell to yourself. Next time I will take care, and within 2-3 days you will come out of that. And the second most important thing, if the failure is coming in your passion way or if it is in a goal, then it is absolutely okay. Learn from it. So whenever failure comes and you face the failure, be the best version of yourself. So hum kehte hai na, when the child is stressed or doing mischief or not listening to you, love him more. Love him more. Right. This is advice for a parent. Or if the child is facing failure or some youngster or an adult is facing the failure, then be the best version of yourself. And just to change the mindset or to relax your mind or to come out with a good solution, spend time with your family. If you enjoy your family, right? And please don't go in negative things or in any kind of substance, addictive substance. Please spend time with your family. And the third most important thing is, listen to the motivational speakers, read good books and find out you are not the only one, and believe that you are not the only one who has faced failure. Right. Whomsoever is successful has faced a lot many times, has faced this lot many times, believe me. And you talk to anyone, you listen to anyone, everybody will say that learn from your failure and don't go into depression. Like I have met few children in of class 10th and 11th, and they were asking from me, why are we leaving, why are we studying, just because they are not able to cope up with the marks which others are expecting from them. We don't want to study, suicide, we exit, you know, children are writing a lot of blogs. They are on Instagram, mm-hmm. that we are exit, we are not able to cope up, we don't want to suffer anymore. Nobody is responsible for your suffering. Mm-hmm. You are responsible for your own happiness and suffering, right? Don't allow others to decide about your happiness. Right? If your children are saying that I'm quitting, I don't want to use anything, I don't want to study anymore. No, exiting is a very easy.
Mm-hmm.
You know, leaving everything is very easy,
right.
But to fight and to achieve is not easy. To be a fighter.
Right, that's just wonderful. I'm sure that I have learned lot many things from her, and I'm sure that you have also learned lot many. It was a wonderful interview with Preeti Kwatra, ma'am. Let's quickly recapitulate what we have been through. The interview was primarily focused for school students, for college going, and the job professionals. Let's quickly recapitulate. Number one, low times are going to come. Life is not easy. It is difficult for all the successful people also. Failures are part of life, and let's start considering our failures as our teachers. These are the steps to face the low times. Spend your time with family. They are your well-wishers. Maybe they are rude at times, but then they are still your well-wishers and they want good for you. Number two, spend time with yourself. Introspection is very important. Just sit at one place, at least for 3 days. Think about what went wrong, what are your learnings, and make a plan. Think of a solution. Before you take any decision, wait for at least 3 days. Number three, listen to motivational speakers and read motivational books, which would pep up your mindset. It's important to love yourself. Always chase your dreams. You can be a leader even if when you are in class 2. You can be a leader when you are 15 years young. You can also be a leader when you are 50 years young. Ensure that you make this deliberate choice and efforts to be happy. Make wise friends. As somebody has said that you are some of 5 people you spend most of your time with. It's very important that you choose your friends wisely. However, as Preeti ma'am suggested, that despite you have got lots of friends, ensure that you go back to your parents to seek their help or seek any of the advice or guidance from them. Believe in yourself. Be determined to choose your goal to be happy and to fulfill your dreams. Ensure that you don't leave any stone unturned. Ensure that you're putting in efforts and prove to the whole world that you were right when you selected your dream. Your dream is your responsibility. Thank you so much once again to Preeti Kwatra, ma'am, for your learning.
Thank you so much.
I have learned a lot, and I'm sure you have also. So we say goodbye from LivesBerg Enterprise.